for launch.
CDR, launch director.
CDR, go ahead.
Eileen, the weather is cooperating tonight. The launch team is ready to go.
Great news, please, ready to go.
MTD, you've got my concurrence to pick up for the clock.
Okay, copy that. And attention all stations, countdown clock will resume in 6 minutes, mark. MTD, ISL.
Good, ISL.
Ops 2 recorder activated. I copy.
And all members of the launch team at Florida and in Houston are ready to resume the launch countdown at T-minus 9 minutes and plan for a launch of Columbia at 12:31 a.m. Eastern Time. About 2 minutes into the flight, the two solid rocket boosters will be jettisoned and will fall into the Atlantic Ocean. About 8.5 minutes after launch, the main engines will cut off, having served their purpose, getting the vehicle into orbit. And lastly, the external tank will be separated from the vehicle a few seconds after main engine cutoff. During ascent, the Capcom in Houston will make routine calls to the crew aboard Columbia, advising them of possible abort modes at different points during their ride into orbit. When the countdown resumes at the T-minus 9 minute mark, the ground launch sequencer will be in control. This is the program that puts commands to perform the final critical task to put the vehicle in launch configuration, monitoring as many as 1,000 different measurements during the final 9 minutes. A few minutes before the launch, the liquid oxygen tank will be pressurized for flight, and as well as the liquid hydrogen tank. And at T-minus 31 seconds, the ground launch sequencer will issue a go to Columbia's onboard computers to start their own automatic sequence. At the 10-second mark, the spark igniters near the main engine nozzles will burn off any residual gaseous hydrogen. And the final command from the ground computers will come at T-minus 10 seconds, which is a go for engine start. And the three engines are actually started at about the T-minus 6.6-second mark and come up to full thrust before the two boosters are ignited right at the T-minus zero mark. All weather continuing to look very good for our planned liftoff of Columbia at 12:31 a.m. There are no technical issues that the launch team is tracking. Everything is looking very good for a liftoff at 12:31.
Countdown clock will resume in 3 minutes.
Got about 2 minutes remaining in this built-in hold at the T-minus 9 minute mark.
Countdown clock will resume in 2 minutes. Mark.
Columbia carrying a crew of five with the Chandra X-ray Observatory. Chandra's high resolving power is equal to the ability to read letters on a stop sign from more than 12 miles away. This telescope is 20 to 50 times more sensitive than any other X-ray telescope. All is quiet here in firing room one as the launch team now monitors the systems on board the Space Shuttle Columbia.
Red MDR.
We're on air to ground. Countdown clock will pick up in 1 minute.
TD, ICTC.
Red ICTC.
Hold fire system enabled. IUS final launch configuration complete.
And I copy ICTC.
Countdown clock will resume on my mark. 3, 2, 1, mark.
T-minus 9 minutes and counting.
COS auto sequence has been initiated.
It's 9 minutes away now from the launch of Columbia on mission STS-93.
Configure the fuel cell essential bus source switches.
CLT in work.
Pilot Ashby now flipping switches in the orbiter's crew cabin to directly connect the fuel cells to the essential power buses.
Copy.
In a few seconds, the orbiter crew access arm will be retracted away from the vehicle and stowed to the launch configuration. This arm can be re-extended in just a few seconds if necessary.
CLS is go for OAA retract.
T-minus 7 minutes and counting. All systems aboard the Shuttle Columbia continue to look very clean. Weather conditions are still go for launch. In the next couple minutes, Pilot Ashby will be performing the auxiliary power unit pre-start and also will be starting the...
Start the APU strip chart recorder. RPS, that is complete.
The auxiliary power units provide hydraulic power to the orbiter.
APU pre-start.
PLT, APU pre-start and work.
T-minus 6 minutes and counting.
DLT, APU pre-start complete, 3 gray contacts.
I copy.
And the auxiliary power units will be started at the T-minus 5 minute mark.
attention all personnel, radio net 105. Maintain silence on net 105 until negative RTLS verified.
TLS verified. Orbiter APU start.
Maintain silence on net 105.
Security console, this is an entity on air to ground.
TLT, perform APU start.
TLT, start APU.
NCDR, reconfigure heaters.
Can we configure work?
Okay. Ground launch sequencer has terminated liquid oxygen replenished to the external tank and is initiating drain back. T-minus 4 minutes and counting. Final purge of the main engines is now starting. The main engine valves are being opened and being prepared for start. A profile test of the orbiter's aero surfaces has started. The orbiter flight control surfaces are being moved through a pre-programmed pattern to verify they are ready for launch. And the three main engines will be gimbaled and positioned for launch. All systems are go for launch at this time. Just a few minutes away from the 26th flight of the shuttle Columbia with a crew of five. T-minus 3 minutes and counting. The liquid oxygen tank is being pressurized for flight. The gaseous oxygen vent hood retraction is now beginning.
TLTN work.
Copy that. Flight crew, close and lock your visors. Initiate O2 flow. A few days delayed, but same enthusiastic launch team wishing Columbia's crew success on your mission.
OTC, CDR, we've got our visors and our O2. Thanks for all the great work, and we'll see you in 5 days.
TLS is go for ETLH2 pressurization.
All systems aboard Columbia continuing to look very clean. 90 seconds away from launch. Chandra is the next of NASA's series of great observatories following the Hubble Space Telescope and the Compton Gamma Ray Observatory. Liquid hydrogen tank being pressurized for flight. T-minus 1 minute and counting. Columbia will be launched on an easterly trajectory on a 28.45 degrees inclination to the equator. T-minus 45 seconds. Less than 1 minute away now from the 95th space shuttle launch. T-minus 35 seconds. T-minus 30 seconds.
25 seconds.
T-minus 20 seconds. T-minus 15. 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. We have a go for engine start. 0, We have booster ignition and liftoff of Columbia, reaching new heights for women in X-ray astronomy.
Booster now controlling.
Booster Columbia is in the roll. We've got a fuel cell pH number one.
Roger, roll, Columbia, we're looking at. Columbia, Houston, we'd like AC bus sensors off. We're evaluating the fuel cell. Columbia.
Okay, that's complete, Scooter.
Roger that, Columbia. Looks like we had a transient on AC-1.
Columbia is now headed downrange, altitude 3.8 miles. And as we hear, all systems okay. It looks like a sensor on board. Three engines throttling down, all at 67%.
Columbia, Houston, we are critical to AC-2 on the center engine, AC-3 on the right. We've lost DCU-A on the center and DCU-B on the right.